most memorable moment would be probably like 3 or 4 retreats ago when the Lord actually convicted me and brought me back to Him, and I just completely started walking with the Lord since then. Brought me back, like completely broke me and then built me up, and then that Sunday morning just refreshed me and started me out new. The time you get to spend to cry and to hear from the Lord together and to worship Him, it's just beautiful. I agree.
It's probably the fact when Pastor John came to talk to me about one of my struggles with sin, right? A certain sin that I struggle with. And, you know, having him come to me personally, it's phenomenal, actually, just to have senior pastors coming to one of his young adults in the church and just explain to him how God loves you, knowing that I am ready to believe that how much God still loves you and who you are.
Just the worship and the intimate time we had with, you know, the brothers and the sisters having their own time, and just it being real personal, just focusing on Jesus and just crying out to Him and not being embarrassed or ashamed, you know, family's watching, but yet just being real and open.
Just showing me how much I need God's mercy, how much I need to be in His Word daily, how much I need to be walking with Him, even when it comes down to my friends, just the friends that I need to be influential in my life at that time, just away from church, everywhere I'm at. So it taught me all that.
Definitely drew me closer to the Lord. I just like went to my room and was reading my Bible all by myself for like a good hour. So it's good sometimes, because then God really speaks to you.
It's not about a mountain experience, but taking back the mountain down with us. So, and I've always remembered that. So.
The retreats affected me, and that as I come back home and as I you know, go to work and as I walk this earth, I go back to the times I retreat when I've been just spoken to by the Lord, and the Lord has spoken to me in awesome and real ways, and applying that and remembering those times and just putting them into action and just applying those things.
It's to be sensitive to the Holy Spirit.
But sometimes we do need to get on our knees. We need to fully surrender to God and just devote our lives to Him, spiritually holy in all that we do. We can't ever seem to take enough time to get away with the Lord.
For all those who are praying about and or considering whether to retreat, invest the money and go. It's a life-changing experience, and you will never forget the friends you meet, and you'll never forget the love the Lord will show you.
Go to the retreat! Seriously, just come. Come for real.
Come to the retreat.
I know.
Yes. See you there.
Boom, 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 boom. Yeah. Anyways, that's gonna be embarrassing now. It's gonna go on, like, all over YouTube.